transformation. So in this method, so today in our today's lecture, we will see network analysis using Laplace transformations. So this is our first lecture on network analysis using Laplace transformation. Laplace transformation. First lecture, lecture 1 on network analysis using Laplace transformations. So first question arises in our mind, why we need a Laplace transformation, why we have to learn a Laplace transformation for a network analysis, right? So when we apply for any series RLC circuit or in parallel RLC circuit, suppose if you want to find out, so this is a f of t, r, l and c, I of t. So suppose we want to find out I of t, we have to apply a KVL. So if we apply KVL, it forms a second order differential equation. R I of t plus voltage across L is L d I of t divided by dt. Voltage across C, it is 1 upon C integrations of I of t dt. So if we differentiate the one times with respect to t, then this is form a second order differential equations is equal to r d I of t divided by dt plus l d square I of t divided by dt square plus I of t divided by c. So it is form a second order differential equations. So solution of this second order differential equation I of t, it's have a particular integral and the complete solutions. So I of t is equal to Ip of t and the Ic of t, right? So Ip of t, that can find from what is the forcing functions, that depends on the forcing functions. Solution of Ip of t depends on the forcing functions. If the forcing function is exponential, then the solution is exponential for the Ip of t. If the forcing function is a sinusoidal signal, then the particular integral is, so it is also a sinusoidal signal. Complete solution, it is an homogeneous differential equation solutions. So adding these two, we'll get the I of t, and to solve the complete solution, we require the initial condition to find out the k1 and k2, right? So the characteristics equation of this second order differential equation is s l s square plus r into s plus 1 upon c is equal to 0. So from this we'll get the two roots of s1 and s2. So ic of t, it is k1 into s1 of t plus k2 into s2 of t. Right. So to find out the k1 and k2, we require the initial condition. We require a I0 plus and the di0 plus divided by dt to find out the k1 and k2. So initial condition is evaluated at the end, and then we'll get the final solutions of I of t. Right. So this is the method in a ordinary differential equation solutions. Now, if we use the Laplace transformations, it will make us very easy to solve the differential equations. So if you use the Laplace transformation, will make easy solution of any differential equations, right? So let first write down the advantage of the Laplace transformations. So Laplace transformation, first advantage of Laplace transformation is the solution of differential equation is routine and progress systematically. The solution of differential equation is routine and progress systematically. Second advantage of Laplace transformation is the method gives the total solutions. The method gives total solution directly without finding the particular integral and the complementary solutions. So it gives the total solution directly, not need to find out the particular integral and the complete solutions. Third advantage of Laplace transformation over classical differential equation solution is the initial condition are automatically specified in a transformed equations, or it is evaluated at a initial stage. The initial condition are automatically specified in the transformed equation. Right. So these are the three advantage of to use the Laplace transformation to solve any differential equations. So Laplace transformation is similar to, like an, it is analogous to the algorithm. It is analogous to the logarithmics, right? So what we are doing to do the complex floating point multiplication and division, rather than to directly multiply the floating points multiplication division, we are finding its logarithm, so that multiplication is converted into the arithmetic. It is converted into the summation, and the division is converted into the subtraction. So to perform the summation and the subtraction is easy compared to perform the multiplication and divisions, right? So Laplace transformation it is analogous to the logarithm. So what are doing in a logarithm? So in a logarithm, we are any number which we want to multiply or divide. Suppose any number, if you want to multiply and divide, yes? Yes, have you any questions? Okay. So if you want to multiply or divide any number, right? So one method is a direct multiplication or division. So we'll get the solution. if we direct multiply and divide, but this method it will take the more times, so we'll get the product or quotient. If you are divide, then we'll get the quotient. Another method is take the logarithm of both the number which we want to multiply or divide. Transform is logarithm of both the number, so we are transforming the number into its logarithmic form, right? So here we'll get the logarithms of numbers. Then this number we will addition or subtraction. Then we'll do the addition or subtraction of this number, right? So here we'll get added or subtraction number of sum of logarithmic number. Then we are doing the anti logarithm to find out the answer. So we'll do the anti logarithm of this product, sum of answer. So one method to multiply both the number is direct multiplication or division, then also we'll get answer. Another method is through the logarithm. So we are converting number into logarithm, and in a logarithm number, if you want to perform the multiplication logarithm, we have to perform the addition. So we have to perform the addition of both the log number, and whatever the answer, we have convert into the anti logarithm, so we'll get the final product answer, right? So Laplace transform, it is a similar process, right? So what we are doing in a Laplace transformation, in a Laplace transformation, we are converting any integral differential equations that we want to solve, right? So here we have the floating number that we want to do the multiplication and division. Logarithm will help us to make it for the easy multiplication and division using the logarithm. Same way, any integral differential equation. Integral differential equation if you want to solve this integral differential equation, one method is directly in a time domain. It is called a classical method. For that we need to find out its particular and complete solution, and we'll get the solutions, right? I of t, that whatever you want to solve solution. Another method is, but the classical method is very lengthy and the time consuming. So another method is, we have to convert the integral differential equations into its Laplace transform. So we have to find out its Laplace transform. So here we'll get a transform equation. Means we are converting a time domain into the S domain. Laplace transform is S domain. At this stage, in a Laplace transform, initial condition is added. So initial condition is evaluated at a first step when we solve any differential equations, right? Then doing the algebraic manipulation. So we'll get the revised transform. Then let's revise transforms. We have to do the inverse Laplace transform to find the answer in a time domain. inverse Laplace transformation. So Laplace transformation, it is a process, it is similar to the algorithmic process, and you know the algorithmic process. So it is analogous to the algorithmic process. In algorithm, to multiply to complex number or to divide a to complex number, we are converting the number into the logarithmic, and then complex multiplication is converted into the additions. So we'll add the two log number, and at the end we'll do the anti-log to find out the final product answer. So same Laplace transform is, it's applied to solve a differential equations. To solve the differential equation in a classical methods, it is a lengthy and a time consuming methods to find out the answers in a classical methods. So if we can convert the differential equations into the Laplace transforms, then it will make us use, that will make us to solution of differential equation very easy, right? So this is the about the Laplace transformations. Now let's see what is the definition of Laplace transforms. So Laplace transformation it convert a time domain signal f of t into a, this is symbol of Laplace transform, into a s domain f of s, right? So s is a complex number, it's have the real plus a imaginary part, so it defined as sigma plus j omega. It is a complex number, sigma plus j omega, right? So if you want to convert any f of t into f of s, so Laplace transform is defined as f of s is equal to summation of 0 to infinite f of t into e raised to minus st, where s is the complex number, sigma plus j omega, into d of t. So if you want to find out the Laplace transform of any signal, we have to multiply that signal into e raised to minus st, and we have to do the integration of 0 to infinite of this product, right? So this is the Laplace transformation of any signals. Now here the necessary condition is that 0 to infinite magnitude of f of t into e raised to sigma t, it should be less than infinite, right? So this product f of t into e raised to sigma t should be less than infinite. So it will decide what is the region of convergence for the Laplace transformations. So real part of s, sigma, it is nothing but the s is equal to sigma plus j omega. So the real part of s, it is sigma, and imaginary part of s, it is omega. So real part of s will decide the region of convergence. Multiplication of f of t, depending on the f of t signal, this real part of s should be, it is decide the region of convergence, what should be the value of sigma, right? So this is the definition to find out a Laplace transformations. So let me find the Laplace transformation to some basic signals. So first basic signal is Laplace transformation of basic signals. So first basic signal is unit step signal. Unit step signal. Definition of unit step signal is, it is defined as u of t, it defined as it is equal to 1 for t greater than equal to 0. and 0 for t less than 0. So this is the definition of u of t, unit step signal, right? So whenever the argument t, here the argument t, whenever the argument is greater than equal to 0, the u of t value is 1, and when the argument is less than 0, then the function value is 0. So if we can plot the t versus u of t, t versus u of t, so for t less than 0, its magnitude is 0, right? For t greater than 0, magnitude is 1. So for t greater than 0, magnitude is 1. So this is signal u of t, right? So here also we can plot its delayed and advanced signal or its multiplication. So suppose if I want to plot a into u of t minus 1, u of t minus 1. So as per the definition, this is value is a is a constant, so a as it is. Now definition of u of t minus 1, right? So argument here the t minus 1, so it is 1 when t minus 1 is greater than equal to 0, because here the argument is t minus 1. So we have to keep the, when argument is t minus 1, if it's greater than equal to 0, the answer of u of t is 1, right? So it is equal to 1 into a, so it is a when t minus 1 greater than equal to 0, so when t is greater than equal to 1, and for the rest of value of t, the answer is 0. A into 0, so it is 0 for t less than 1. So when t greater than 1, u a into u of t minus value is a. When t less than 1, magnitude of a into u of t minus 1 is 0. So it can be plot like this, t versus u of a into u of t minus 1. Right, so 1 somewhere here, so from greater than t is equal to 1, here the magnitude is a, not a 1, right? And for t less than 1, magnitude is 0, magnitude is equal to 0. So u of a into u of t minus 1. Similarly, for any advanced signals, so if I want to plot a b into u of t plus 1, so it is equal to b into 1 when t plus 1 greater than equal to 0. So it is equal to b into 1, so it is b when t is greater than equal to minus 1. If we take the 1 on this side, so it is minus 1. And for rest of value of t, opposite condition of this, value is b into 0, so b into 0 is 0, so for t less than a minus 1, t less than the minus 1, right? So this can be plot at t b into u of t plus 1. So minus 1 is somewhere here, right? So when t is greater than minus t, value is b, so here it is an b, and for the less of minus t, value is 0. So it can be plot b into u of t plus 1, it can be plot like this. Similarly, time reversal signals, suppose if the u of minus t, so u of minus t defined as, it is 1 when minus t greater than equal to 0. So it is 1 when t less than 0. It is 1 when t less than 0, right? T less than equal to 0, or t less than 0, right? So, and it is a 0 when t greater than 0. So it can be plot like, for the negative value of t, For when t less than 0, its amplitude is 1. So for t less than 0, amplitude is 1. And for t greater than 0, amplitude is 0. And this signal is nothing but the u of minus t, time reversal of u of t. It is called a u of minus t. Right? Any time reversal of u of t, it is called a u of minus t. So this signal, it is called a unit step signal. Unit step signal. It is value change in a step from its direct slope is infinite. So value changing in a step, not linearly or not exponentially. If the value change in a step, so it is called a step signal. And if the amplitude is 1, then it's called a unit step signals. Now our interest is to find out the Laplace transform of a unit step signals. So let's find the Laplace transform of unit step signal. First basic signal is unit step signal. So let me find the Laplace transform of unit step signals. Laplace transform of unit step signals, right? So we know the definition of Laplace transform. We have to integrate the f of t. So here the f of t is u of t. So we have to integrate the u of t for 0 to infinite, and it is multiplied with e raised to minus st. And then the product is integrate the 0 to infinite with respect to time to find out the Laplace transform of any signals, right? Now what is the definition of u of t? So u of t is equal to 1 for t greater than equal to 0, and it is 0 for t less than 0. So our integral time range is 0 to infinite. So in this time range u of t value is 1, right? So Laplace transformation of u of t, it is equal to for 0 to infinite u of t value is 1. So it's have to 1 e raised to minus st dt. So we have to do the integration of e raised to minus st dt. So integration of e raised to minus st is e raised to minus st divided by minus s divided by minus s. And this is the range is 0 to infinite. 0 to infinite. Right? So if we integrate this, so if we integrate this, let's substitute the upper limit. So e raised to minus infinite divided by minus s minus lower limit e raised to 0 minus s. So e raised to minus infinite is equal to 0. So 0 minus minus plus and e raised to 0 is 1. Okay. So Laplace transformation of u of t, it is equal to 1 upon s. Laplace transformation of u of t is equal to 1 upon s. It is also called u of s. Laplace transformation of u of t, unit step signal, is 1 upon s. Okay. Now let's find the Laplace transformation of another basic signal. And it is a exponential signals. So let's find the Laplace transformation of f of t. It is equal to e raised to at. So let's find the Laplace transformation of exponential signal e raised to at. So we know the definition f of s is equal to summation of 0 to infinite f of t into e raised to minus st into dt. Substitute the value of f of t, so it is 0 to infinite f of t, it is e raised to at into e raised to minus st dt. So two exponential signal is in multiplication, so it is 2 minus t, let's say common, so in bracket it is s minus a into dt. So integration of e raised to minus s minus a, it is e raised to minus t s minus a divided by minus s minus a. Limit is 0 to infinite. So if you substitute the upper limit, it is minus infinite divided by minus s minus a minus lower limit e raised to 0 divided by minus s minus a. So e raised to minus infinite is 0 and minus minus plus, and e raised to 0 is 1, s minus a. So Laplace transformation of e raised to at is equal to 1 upon s minus a. Suppose the signal is e raised to, suppose f of t is equal to e raised to minus at, then the Laplace transformation of e raised to minus at is 1 upon s plus a. So the Laplace transformation of e raised to plus or minus at, it is equal to 1 upon s minus plus a, right? So Laplace transformation of any signal which is e raised to plus or minus at, its Laplace transform is 1 upon s minus plus a. Now let's find the Laplace transformation of next basic signal. It is a sinusoidal signal. So we have covered unit step signal, exponential signals. Now third signal, it is a sinusoidal signals. So suppose the f of t is equal to any sine or cos signal, let's say it is sine omega t. Now let's find the Laplace transform of these signals, right? So Laplace transformation of sine omega t is equal to 0 to infinite sine omega t, that multiply with e raised to minus st into dt. Sine omega t, using the Euler's formula, we can represent the sinusoidal signal into the exponential signals. So sine omega t, it can represent e raised to j omega t minus e raised to minus j omega t divided by 2j. So this is the representation of a sine using the exponential signals e raised to minus st and dt. Now let multiply the e raised to minus st to the both the exponential signal e raised to j omega t and e raised to minus j omega t. So e raised to j omega t into e raised to minus st minus e raised to minus j omega t into e raised to minus st divided by 2j into e raised to dt. Now e raised to j omega t into e raised to minus st, let's take the minus t common, then it is s minus j omega, and minus, let's take the minus t common, then it is s plus j omega divided by 2j into dt. Let's do the integration of both the term e raised to minus t s minus j omega and integration of e raised to minus t s plus j omega. Then it is, let's take the 1 upon 2j common, integrations of e raised to minus t s minus j omega divided by minus s minus j omega minus e raised to minus t s plus j omega divided by minus s plus j omega. upper limit is infinite and lower limit is 0. Now let's substitute the upper and lower limit. So by substituting the upper and lower limit, 1 upon 2j, upper limit is infinite, so e raised to minus infinity is 0 and e raised to minus infinity is 0. If we substitute the lower limits, so here it is minus minus plus, minus is this and minus of lower limit, so minus minus plus, so 1 upon s minus j omega and minus 1 upon s plus j omega. Okay. So after substituting the limit, we will get 1 upon s minus j omega minus 1 upon s plus j omega. Let's simplify it. So Laplace transformation of sine omega t, it is equal to 1 upon 2j, 1 upon s minus j omega minus 1 upon s plus j omega. Let's simplify it. So 1 upon 2j s plus j omega by taking the LCM, minus s plus j omega divided by s minus j omega multiplied by s plus j omega. So ss cancel. So in numerator it is 2j omega divided by 2j, so it is only the omega, and in denominator a minus b into a plus b, so it is s square minus b square, so a is s and b is equal to j omega, so j omega square. Now j square, it is equal to minus 1, so minus minus plus, so s square plus omega square. So Laplace transformation of sine omega t, it is equal to omega divided by s square plus omega square, omega divided by s square plus omega square. Similarly, let's find the Laplace transformation of the cos signal. So once we find the Laplace transform of the cos signal using the same method, then it will be the s divided by s square plus omega square, s divided by s square plus omega square. Right, same, exactly same procedure we can apply to find out the Laplace transform of cos signals. So when we applied Laplace transform cos signal, the cos omega t, it represent in exponential is e raised to omega t minus e raised to minus omega t divided by 2. So representation of cos signal, representation of cos signal into a here to j omega t plus e raised to j omega t divided by 2. So this is the representation of a cos omega t into the exponential signals, right? Similarly, we can find Laplace transform of any hyperbolic sine and cos signals. So let me find the Laplace transformation of hyperbolic sine and cos signals. Hyperbolic sine and cosine signals. So f of t, suppose it is hyperbolic sine, sine h t, hyperbolic sine, sine h omega t, sine h omega t. So we know, let's find the hyperbolic sine h omega t Laplace transform, 0 to infinite sine h omega t into e raised to minus st dt, as per the definition of Laplace transforms. then let it represent the hyperbolic sign into the exponential signals. So hyperbolic sign, it represent into exponential, it is e raised to omega t minus e raised to minus omega t divided by 2, divided by 2, right, into e raised to minus st dt. Let multiply e raised to minus st into e raised to omega t and e raised to minus omega t. So 0 to infinite e raised to omega t into e raised to minus st minus e raised to minus omega t into e raised to minus st divided by 2 into dt. So exponential signal are in multiplication, so let's take the minus t common from both. It is s minus omega, and here let's take the minus t common, it is s plus omega divided by 2. Let's do the integration of e raised to minus t s minus omega. So here 1 upon 2 integrations of e raised to minus t s minus a and s minus omega divided by minus s minus omega minus e raised to minus t s plus omega divided by minus s plus omega. Lower limit is 0, upper limit is infinite. Let's substitute the upper and lower limit. So if we substitute the upper limit, e raised to minus infinity is 0. So lower limit minus minus plus, e raised to 0 is 1. So 1 upon s minus omega minus 1 upon s plus omega. Let's simplify this to find out the Laplace transform of hyperbolic sine signals. So Laplace transform of hyperbolic sine signal, it is 1 upon 2 1 upon s minus omega minus 1 upon s plus omega. Let's simplify it by taking the LCM. So s plus omega minus s plus omega division by s minus omega and s plus omega. S cancel, so omega 2 omega 2 to cancel, so it is omega divided by s minus omega and s plus omega, so it is s square minus omega square. So this is Laplace transformation of hyperbolic sine signals. Hyperbolic sine signal. Omega divided by s square minus omega square. Similarly, the Laplace transformation of cos hyperbolic signal, it is s divided by s square minus omega square. S square minus omega square. Now let's find the Laplace transformation of the signal, which is the two signal multiplications. If we multiply a exponential signal with the sinusoidal signal, so let's find the Laplace transformation of f of t. It is equal to e raised to minus st sine omega t, sine omega t. Let me find the Laplace transform of a signal sine of t, which is multiplication with exponential signal e raised to minus st. So let me find the Laplace transformation of e raised to minus at sine omega t. So it is 0 to infinite signal. Signal is e raised to minus st sine omega t into e raised to minus st dt. Let represent the sine omega t into the exponential form. So e raised to minus st sine into exponential form e raised to j omega t minus e raised to minus j omega t divided by 2j into e raised to minus st dt. let multiply the exponential signal and 1 upon 2j common. So by multiplying the exponential signal, so it is e raised to nt, let it t common. If you multiply e raised to minus st, at e raised to j omega t, e raised to minus st, by taking the minus t common, so it is s plus a minus j omega. Minus e raised to minus t, let take the minus t common, then it is s plus a plus j omega into dt. Let integrate the both the terms, so 1 upon 2j, integrations of e raised to minus t s plus a minus j omega is e raised to minus t s plus a minus j omega divide minus s plus a minus j omega minus e raised to minus t s plus a plus j omega divide by minus s plus a plus j omega. Upper limit is 0, upper limit is infinite and lower limit is 0. E raised to minus infinite is equal to 0. So let directly substitute the lower limit, minus of lower limit. So if you do the minus, so minus minus plus, e raised to 0 is 1. So 1 upon s plus a minus j omega minus 1 upon s plus a plus j omega. Let's simplify it. So it is 1 upon 2j by taking the LCM. So it is s plus a plus j omega minus a minus s plus j omega divide by s plus a minus j omega multiply by s plus a plus j omega. So here s a s a cancel, so it is 2j omega, so divide by 2j, so it is only the omega. So if you multiplied the exponential signal with any sinusoidal signal, then 1 upon 2 omega divided by s plus a minus j omega into s plus a plus j omega. So it is s plus a no square minus omega square. So minus minus plus. So it is a plus omega square plus omega square. So this is the Laplace transform of e raised to minus a t sin omega t. So if you multiplied in a time domain the exponential signal, then in frequency domain it is shifted by a. It is shifted by a. So similarly, if we multiplied e raised to minus a t to cos signal, so wherever you will see s of Laplace transform of cos omega t, we have to substitute instead of s, it is s plus a, because here we have multiplied e raised to minus a t. So in a Laplace domain, in a s domain, signal is shifted by value of s, so mean value of a, right? So Laplace transform of cos omega t is s divided by s square plus omega square. So wherever it will be s, here we have to substitute s plus a. So Laplace transform of e raised to minus a t cos omega t, it is s plus a divided by s plus a square plus omega square. Similarly, this rule is also applicable if we multiply it with the hyperbolic sine and cos signal. So if we multiply signal with a hyperbolic sine signal, so we know for the hyperbolic sine signal, Laplace transformation of hyperbolic sine signal, it is omega divided by s square minus omega square. So if we multiply the hyperbolic sine with e raised to minus a t, then its Laplace transform is omega. Here it is s, so instead of s, it is s plus a no square minus omega square. Similarly, Laplace transform of hyperbolic cos h omega t multiplication with e raised to minus a t, wherever the s. So cos h omega t Laplace transform is s divided by s square minus omega square. So Laplace transform e raised to minus a t cos omega t is s plus a divided by s plus a square minus omega square minus omega square. So if we multiply the any signal in a time domain, it is shifted by value in a frequency domain. So here we have multiplied with e raised to plus a t. If we multiplied with e raised to minus a t, so if you want to multiply e raised to a t sine omega t, then Laplace transform is omega divided by s minus a square plus omega square. Similarly, if we multiplied the minus instead of minus, if we multiply plus omega t with cos omega t, then it is s minus a divided by s minus a square plus omega square. Right? So this was, now let me see for the some more basic signal Laplace transformations. So we have seen the Laplace transformation of u of t is 1 upon s, right? Now Laplace transform of t is 1 upon s square, and the Laplace transform of t raised to n, where n is any integer number, then it is n factorial divided by s raised to n plus 1. So Laplace transform of t raised to 2, it is 2 factorial divided by s into 3. Laplace transform of t raised to 3, it is the 3 factorial divided by s raised to 4, like that. Similarly, Laplace transform of any exponential signal plus or minus a t, Laplace transform of exponential signal, it is 1 upon s minus plus a. 1 upon s minus plus a. If we multiply the t with any exponential signals, so if we multiply t with e raised to a t, right? So we know the Laplace transform of t is 1 upon s square. So we have to squaring of e raised to a t. So e raised to a t Laplace transform is 1 upon s plus a. So Laplace transform of e raised to t into a t is 1 upon s plus a no square. 1 upon s minus a no square. S minus a no square. Okay. Similarly, if multiplied t with the sinusoidal signal, suppose if you multiply t with omega t, sine omega t, then we know the Laplace transform of sine omega t is omega divided by s square plus omega square. So if you multiply with t, then its Laplace transform is 2 omega s divided by s square plus omega s no square. Okay. Laplace transform is 2 omega s divided by s square plus omega square no square, s square plus omega square s2 square. So this is about the Laplace transform of some basic signals. Laplace transform of some basic signals. So let me stop our this lecture here.